Namaste students, after completion of exercise problems of chapter 1, today we will start chapter 2, acids, bases and salts. Students, first of all, we should know about origin of acid, bases and salt. We know that matter, on the basis of chemical properties, classified into two parts, pure substance and impure substance, that is mixture, and this pure substance further divided into two parts, element and compound. And these compounds either may be organic and inorganic. Organic and inorganic, we know about compound. Compound is the part of pure substance having same kind of molecules, and these molecules made up of hydrocarbon and its derivatives. It is known as organic compound, and more details knowledge about this organic compound will be discussed in chapter 4. Carbon and its compound, and this other part of compound, inorganic, rest compound excluding hydrocarbon and its derivatives known as inorganic. So compound are of two types, either organic or inorganic. And this organic and inorganic compound further classified into either acid, base and salt. In previous knowledge, we know that acid are sour in taste, bases are bitter in taste, and when acid react with base to form salt and water, it is also known as neutralization reaction. So when acid treated with base to form salt and water. So students, the nature of compound, the nature of compounds, either organic or inorganic, may be acidic, basic or neutral. That means the nature of acid, base and salt, which is the part of compound, organic or inorganic compound, is either acidic, basic or neutral. So on the basis of classical concept, we know that acids are sour in taste, bases are bitter in taste, but we can taste those materials which is edible materials can be tested with tongue, but in our laboratory there are different kind of chemicals which are very harmful, so these materials cannot be tested with the help of tongue, and on the basis of taste we cannot classify as acidic, basic or neutral. So students, we introduce a new term for identification of acidic, basic or neutral substance. So we use a new term, acid base indicator. Acid base indicator, simply it is also known as indicator. So students, indicator is a dye colored substance that changes the color when it is put into acid or base solution. In simply, indicator identify the nature of chemical substance indicator identify the nature of chemical substance either acidic, basic or neutral. So we use indicator to identify the nature of chemical substance either acidic, basic or neutral. So students, there are different types of indicator. There are different types of indicators which are given below. Number one, natural indicator artificial indicator, it is also known as synthetic indicator. Third one, olfactory indicator, And fourth one, universal indicator or pH paper. These are the different kinds of indicators in which we can identify the nature of chemical substances into acidic form, basic form, or neutral form. So let us start about natural indicator. Natural indicator. Indicator that is directly obtained from nature. Indicator that is directly obtained from nature is known as natural indicator. And their examples are litmus, turmeric, powder, red cabbage, extract, etc. These are the examples of natural indicator that is obtained from nature, and that's why it is known as natural indicator. So most important natural indicator is litmus. Litmus is a natural indicator because it is obtained from lichen plant. It is obtained from lichen plant, which belongs to Thallophyta division. Thallophyta division is the part of biology. Just only we have to know about why it is natural, because it is obtained from lichen plant, which belongs to Thallophyta division. Its color is purple, and purple color is the mixture of red and blue colors. Purple means mixture of red and blue colors. So this litmus is of two types: blue litmus and red litmus. Blue litmus and red litmus. The students, when blue litmus put into acidic solution, it turns into red. Acid turns blue litmus to red litmus, while bases, that is base turns red litmus to blue litmus. A litmus, that is blue, put into solution and the color of blue litmus change into red, then this type of solution having acidic nature and a solution that turns red litmus to blue litmus, such type of solution is said to be basic, and that solution having no effect of the color of blue litmus or red litmus, this solution is said to be neutral. That substance, that chemical substance in the form of solution is neutral. So using natural indicator in the form of litmus, we can identify the nature of acidic, basic or neutral material. One thing I want to clear here, acid, base and salt, and the nature of salt may be the nature of salt may be either acidic, basic or neutral, which will be discussed in topic salt. So students, by using litmus, when blue litmus change into red, the nature of particular substance is acidic and the solution that turns red litmus to blue, the nature of solution is basic, and that solution having no effect on either blue litmus or red litmus, it is said to be neutral. So students, prepare notes and solve in text problem. In text problems regarding this topic, which is given in NCERT book. Thank you.